able to do the examinations without a hitch. Right, over 1 million candidates are sitting for this year's national examinations. Out of that number, rather, 11 candidates from the Kingongo prison in Nyeri County are also sitting for this exam. So right now, I'd like us to cross over to Nyeri County and talk to our very own Clement Masombo, who's keeping tabs with the national examinations. Masombo, good morning, and thank you so much for speaking to us here on KTN News Center. 11 candidates from Kingongo prison sitting for these exams, are they ready and excited?
Good morning, Brenda. Just like you rightly put it, even as the KCPE exams, are set to begin tomorrow, rehearsals are on today, and currently I'm at the Nyeri main prison, that is, it's also called Kingongo prisons. And it's not 11 candidates, they are 13 candidates. So I'm in the examination room, and everything seems to be right. The invigilators are here busy trying to maybe do their final touches. And just ensuring that as the exercise starts tomorrow, everything will be okay. And we shall just be speaking to some of the candidates and even some of the teachers who are the prison wards who have been with these candidates, ensuring that they prepare them adequately and efficiently for this exam that starts tomorrow. And Brenda, just to let you know that last year they had about 15 candidates, and the top candidate emerged with 328 marks. So that shows that at least in as much as they are in prison, there is also a room for them to perform better. So right now, let me speak to the head teacher of this particular institution who has been in charge of these candidates, just ensuring that they are prepared well for this exam. So thank you so much for joining us. We are live on KTN News. Kindly tell us your name and how has it been interacting with these candidates so far?
Okay, my name is Wesley Kerui. Interacting with this inmate has been very good. It is just like any other students out there.
How could you say they are prepared, the level of preparedness as far as KCP exams is concerned?
Okay, we have prepared these students very well. Right here we have 10 trained teachers, and then we have also 21 inmate trained teachers, totaling about 31 teachers. So as you can see, we have prepared these students very well.
And maybe, Mr. Kiriu, is there any challenge that you can highlight that you have been faced while interacting with the inmates and preparing them for the exams, maybe?
Yeah, we have very many challenges here in prison. The first one may be time management here, maybe, because we have very, very many activities inside this facility. So time, completing syllabus and the rest has been a problem. The second one, maybe we don't have the new materials. As you know that we have the new curriculum. So we don't have books which suit the new curriculum. Another thing is maybe we depend mostly on the well-wishers to give us books, to give us other things. So that maybe that's one of the challenges we have in this facility.
And Mr. Kiriu, to finalize with you, is there anything that maybe you feel like the government should do in order to ensure that the inmates also get enough time or just to make their learning better while in prisons?
Okay. The government can do something maybe in terms of providing the materials. I've talked of the new curriculum. I've talked of these other facilities like books and the rest. And anyway, the government have been assisting us. They have done their best.
Okay, thank you so much. So Brenda, let me speak to some of the candidates here and also hear from them what they have to say concerning this particular exam that is set to begin tomorrow. And as they are seated here, what are their expectations? So asante sana kwa kujiunga na sisi. Naomba utuambie jina lako nani, alafu wewe matarajio yako ni gani unapoanza mtihani wako kesho?
Okay, majina yangu ni Efantas Mutahi Kirugi. Mimi mfungwa na sukuma kifungo ya maisha since 2003, na matarajio yangu ni kupita mtihani. Ni kwa sababu tumefundishwa kutosha na walimu wetu, na si ni kwa nini tusipate alama ya juu. Kwa sababu hata igawa kuna challenges nyingi, lakini walimu wanajaribu kupigana na hiyo, kututafutia wafadhili. Kama tulikuwa na shida ya vitabu, tunapata vitabu. Kwa hivyo tunatarajia kesho tutaanza mtihani yetu, tumetayarishwa ya kutosha. Na pia tungeomba serikali ilete usaidizi upande ya shule, kwa sababu hii shule ya jela iko na mambo muhimu sana inaturekebisha sisi kama wafungwa, kwa sababu huenda tukiingia gerezani tulitenda vitendo ambaye haikufurahisha wananchi. Lakini wakati tumeingia gerezani tunakuta kuna mambo mengi sana tunafundishwa ambaye hatuku patana naye kule nje. Unakuta kuna mtu aliingia gerezani hakujiunga hata na standard 1, lakini akifika hapa anapata masomo, anajua kuandika jina yake, anajua kusoma na kuandika. Kwa hivyo serikali wakati inahesabu zile shule ziko katika nchi ya Kenya, inafaa kuhuzisha hata hii shule ya gereza, kwa sababu hii ndio inafanya kasi kubwa sana kurekebisha mtu ambaye alikuwa ana mienendo mibaya, na dakika ya mwisho akitoka, kwa sababu wakati ule hakupata mafundisho, anatoka akiwa na mafundisho ya kutosha na anakuwa raia mwema.
Naam, na umesema tu kuwa kuna challenges ambazo umepitia. Taja kama moja ya mama mbili hivi ambazo wewe umekumbana nazo wakati ambapo unajihusisha na masomo yako hapa ndani.
Kitu ya kwanza, hapa gerezani unakuta serikali haipatiani ufadhili ya vitu kama mandalaza. Sasa unakuta zile mandalaza tunasomea, unakuta hizo hizo tu ndizo nyumba tunatumia kwa kazi zingine kama mahali pa kulala. Lakini kama serikali ingetenga pesa isaidie idara ya magereza,